Imagine a tiny hole in a tank's armor, barely wide enough for a finger to squeeze through. To the untrained eye, it looks almost innocent. Yet through that small opening, a machine can be killed outright. In today's video, we explain how that happens. The shaped charge, or cumulative, effect. The idea behind the shaped charge is older than most people think. An American chemist, Charles E. Munroe, discovered in the late 19th century that an explosive can be made to concentrate its energy if its charge contains a cavity shaped like a cone. But that insight remained a laboratory curiosity for decades, until the age of tanks forced engineers back to the problem. When armored warfare became widespread in the 1940s, armies looked for ways to kill tanks. At first, they answered with bigger guns, but every jump in muzzle energy was met by thicker and heavier armor. Anti-tank infantry responded with grenades and mines, but something new was needed. A weapon that attacked not with sheer mass, but by concentrating energy. The breakthrough came when ordnance designers took Munroe's idea and refined it. If the explosive cavity is lined with a soft, malleable metal, copper, for example, then under detonation the lining does not merely crumple. Instead, driven by the explosive force and the cone's geometry, it collapses inward and then shoots forward in a thin, high-speed jet. Here's how it works in the split second after impact. The fuse, placed at the rear of the shell, triggers the explosive charge on contact. The explosion moves forward, and the cone-shaped cavity collapses. Under enormous pressure, the metal liner peels and forms a jet, not a solid slug, but a stream of metal particles and filaments moving at extraordinary velocity. That jet can reach about 10 kilometers per second. That's 10,000 meters per second, roughly 32,800 feet per second, about 22,370 miles per hour. In other words, it moves at hypersonic speed. The pressure at the jet's tip is almost unimaginable. Estimates put it on the order of 100 tons per square centimeter, roughly 9.8 times 10 to the ninth pascals, or about 1.42 million pounds per square inch. That focus of force doesn't cut like a knife so much as force the armor to flow. The jet punches, melts locally, and literally forces armor metal out of the way by plastic deformation. In plain terms, it shoves, melts, and washes the armor aside. In the early years, Germany was the first to field these weapons in quantity, and Soviet crews often found puzzling damage, small round holes and blown components, that looked at first like burning rather than penetration. But captured samples of shaped charge ammunition made the picture clear. Artillery and infantry weapons were soon produced to use the same principle: anti-tank shells, hollow charge grenades, and anti-tank mines. A shaped charge's front is usually fitted with an aerodynamic cap to preserve flight and ensure the charge hits the target at the right angle. Inside, the cone is lined with a ductile metal such as copper. Behind it lies the explosive and the fuse. On impact, the explosive drives the liner forward and collapses it into that deadly jet. The hole left behind can be narrow, just a few centimeters across, but the damage behind it is catastrophic. The jet's temperature reaches several hundred degrees Celsius, even 600 degrees Celsius, about 1,112 degrees Fahrenheit, is often quoted for the hot particles in the flow. But the jet is not the only killer. When it pierces the armor, it fragments the inner surface. Tiny metal shards and molten droplets spray into the crew compartment. Those fragments act like a sandblaster of metal, often small as grains of sand. But traveling at enormous speed, they shred instruments, ignite ammunition, tear hoses, and wound the crew. If the jet hits the engine, fuel, or stored rounds, it can trigger secondary explosions that wreck the vehicle instantly. As the shaped charge spread across battlefields, countermeasures followed quickly. One simple trick is to force the charge to detonate at an offset from the main armor. Add an external screen or a spaced armor plate a short distance from the hull. A shaped charge that detonates on that screen forms its jet too early, and the jet disperses before it reaches the main armor. In practice, even a light outer plate mounted with a gap will drastically reduce penetration. A far more advanced defense is explosive reactive armor, ERA, invented and refined after the Second World War, with major developments in the Soviet Union. ERA consists of small sandwich blocks mounted on the hull, each with a sheet of explosive between metal plates. When an incoming shaped charge hits a block, the explosive layer detonates outward. That moving plate collides with the incoming jet, disrupting and partially neutralizing its energy. The result? The jet is broken up, its focus lost, and it often can't pierce the underlying main armor. Modern ERA is controlled and sequenced. Today's tanks may use computer-guided sensors to detect incoming projectiles and time counter detonations to maximize effect. Active protection systems, APS, take this a step further. Radar and optical sensors detect a shot in flight and launch interceptors, small munitions that intercept or pre-detonate the warhead before it hits. APS can defeat both kinetic and shaped charge threats at distances too small for reactive armor to help. Even so, signs of a shaped charge hit remain distinctive. From outside, the wound is often a small round hole, a few centimeters in diameter. But inside, the damage is brutal. Melted and eroded armor, shredded equipment, and fragments everywhere. Crews rarely survive the cascade of effects if the hit causes ammunition or fuel to detonate. Modern shaped charges have not stood still. Advances in liner materials, explosive formulations, and charge geometry, along with tandem warheads, a small precursor charge followed by a main charge, have pushed penetration capabilities even further. Today, some tandem and advanced heat warheads, high explosive anti-tank, are claimed to defeat armor more than a meter thick. That's over 3 feet, roughly 3.28 feet or about 39 inches, of rolled homogeneous armor equivalent. Though real-world results always depend on standoff distance, target angle, and protective systems in place. In short, a shaped charge turns explosive energy into a focused, hypersonic stream that behaves like a driven chisel and a sandblaster at once. Small on the outside, devastating on the inside. The technology that started as a curious laboratory observation in the 1800s became, by the mid-20th century, one of the defining weapons of armor warfare. And the race between armor and anti-armor continues to this day. If you found this explanation useful, subscribe for more deep dives into the weapons and machines that changed battlefields, explained clearly and without the myths. That's all for today. Share your thoughts in the comments below. If you found this interesting, don't forget to subscribe. And share this video with anyone who loves the tanks and all around it. Thank you for watching. And as always, stay curious.